Well, every now and then the internet gets inspired to come together and make something good happen. Today we got the very best kind of good thing in the form of a magpie and his best mate.
It's a love story for the ages. Molly the magpie and Peggy the Staffy might seem like a strange pair, but from the moment Paw touched Claw, their unlikely friendship began to blossom. Gold Coast couple Juliet Wells and Reese Mortensen rescued Molly as a chick after he fell from his nest at a local park back in 2020. And while they never caged Molly or forced him to stay with them, the little bird quickly formed an unbreakable bond with Peggy, as well as their other pup, Ruby, even learning to speak their language. Their story quickly formed a cult following, which grew to millions and even led to a book deal.
He's made an incredible bond with our two girls, our two Staffy girls.
But a month ago, the Queensland Environment Department seized Molly, saying the couple didn't have the required permit to care for native wildlife.
Peggy, I think, because she's a very sensitive soul, she's been really depressed. It breaks our heart every day to think that Molly's lost, feeling alone, confused, as we all are.
To say the move ruffled a few feathers is an understatement, with everyone from pollies to pro surfers campaigning to reunite the bona fide besties.
This wild magpie made these Staffies its family.
This bird chooses to stay with this family.
Give it back to the dog that it's been mates with for the last 5 years.
After 40 days of anticipation and more than 150,000 signatures on multiple petitions to bring Molly home, today, good news finally came.
We have identified a pathway for them to secure an appropriate permit so that Molly can be returned home.
A happy ending for two star-crossed pals, set to be reunited at last.
Our hearts are really happy right now. We really look forward to speaking with the department tomorrow to finalise a solution to bring Molly home.
There is some good in the world. Peter Gleeson is the Drive Show host on 4BC in Brisbane and he's been calling for Molly to be returned. Peter, how did you react when you heard the good news?
I was just so relieved, guys. I mean, you know, it's such a big story here in Queensland. The amount of people who actually rang through and texted through after we sort of concentrated on this story was extraordinary. It sort of outstripped the Olympic Games and youth justice here in Queensland. People were very invested in it. And I also felt like it was a good sign for the Premier, Stephen Miles, who's been under a lot of pressure, because if he couldn't reunite a bird with the family that had adopted them, I was really worried about how the 2032 Olympics was going to go.
Peter, why do you think Queensland has gotten such a flap about this story?
It's a really good question, Matt. I think it comes down to the fact that those wonderful images that we saw on Facebook of Molly with Peggy the dog, they were just so heartwarming. And people were really invested in the fact that the government had intervened. You know, the big government is something that people aren't particularly impressed with these days. Some overzealous bureaucrat had got involved, had decided that they were going to take Molly away from that family who had adopted her. You know, they'd become very close. And I think Queensland has really embraced that family and embraced Molly so much. And when they realised that they'd been taken away, they felt that there was an injustice and it needed to be remedied.
Exactly, Peter. Queenslanders, we're a tight-knit community. Now, this happened because of a small group of people making complaints. Surely that is very un-Queenslander of them.
Mm. Well, sort of whinging. I mean, I would have thought that, you know, New South Wales and Victoria were the ones that would whinge about something like this. But Queensland are very up when it comes to this sort of stuff in sort of, you know, making sure we get behind the underdog. But in this situation, we had someone who whinged. And look, there is another side to this, and I actually had a call today from a wildlife officer who said, you know, there are a lot of people who will actually take in a stray bird or a stray kangaroo and feed them the wrong food, and then all of a sudden they're in strife. So there was always that point that we had to make sure that we kept abreast of.
Hmm. What isn't part of Queensland culture, Georgie Tunney?
Whinging.
Whinging?
Yeah,
okay.
We've established that. Whinging.
Building stadiums, maybe?
We're working on,
We're working on that. Now, Peter, how did we even get here with the government? I feel like this is my talkback radio moment. What, there's so many other things they need to worry about. Why were they getting so worked up over Molly?
Well, I think it came back to the fact there was an overzealous bureaucrat. The issue here was that we had a bird that had been adopted by a family. The bird was in wonderful spirits, got on beautifully with the dog at home. We saw all those wonderful visions, vision of those two sort of playing together. And then it became a national, in fact, it became an international story. It was picked up by a whole range of different media organisations throughout the world. So I think sanity prevailed today, and good luck to the Premier. He hasn't had many wins lately. He's finally had a win.
All right, Peter, this is the story we needed this week.
It really
Thank you
is.
For your time.
Cheers, guys.